Hey, everyone. This is Knox.
And this Robert. This is Jason.
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 This is Jason. As you can see, I'm back home. I'm in my room on my computer, on the good microphone, and I'm back. Things are back to normal.
Normal.
Give me an e hug.
Yeah, I don't think I want to e hug you today.
Give me an e hug.
I don't think I want an e hug.
Okay, what about an e handshake?
I can do an e handshake.
All right, here we go.
We're e handshaking.
Yeah, we are.
Your hands are kind of sweaty.
They are. I've been doing some exercising.
Yeah, I can tell your arms feel all muscly.
I climbed on top of a convenience store today.
You did?
Yes, I'm the king of the convenience stores. Did you hear?
No, I didn't hear that. That's pretty. You actually climbed on a convenience store.
Yeah, I did. Remember the guy who like climbed buildings or something? What was his name? Like Spider-Man or something?
Yeah.
Like the human spider or something like that. He like climbed on top of buildings. Well, I climb on top of convenience stores.
Really?
I mean,
yeah. Did you actually like climb on a convenience store today?
I actually did.
That is crazy. What made you climb on this particular convenience store?
I wanted to climb on something, and the convenience store was the closest thing to me, so I climbed on top of a convenience store. I got a free slushie.
You got a free slushie?
Free slushie. It was a Coke slushie, though, which I don't like. It was bad. It was really bad.
That's too bad.
But I got a free pickle, too. He gave me a pickle.
Oh, everyone likes free pickles.
I got a free pickle. I drank the juice.
I have never in my entire life gotten a free pickle.
You have never gotten a free pickle?
I have actually climbed on buildings to film stuff. I've climbed on top of buildings and stores and everything.
Wow, really?
Yeah, but I've never gotten anything free out of it.
That's cool.
Yeah.
You need to climb on top of a convenience store, and you'll get a free pickle.
I really do want a free pickle.
Dude, I swear to God, if you just climb on stuff, people will give you free crap.
They better.
You climb on top of crap.
The background music I'm playing is, today is Herb Alpert and the Tijuana Brass. It was recommended to me by Shia, actually.
Who's that?
It's someone who's been messaging me, and she recommended this particular album. I heard it. She made this animation thing, and it had this in the background. And I was like, "What music is that?" And she let me know, and it's now one of my favorite albums.
Who the hell is Shia?
Someone who messages me, man.
Who messages you?
Like one or two people.
I thought I was the only one who messaged you.
I got every once in a while people actually pay attention to me. I mean, you know, I wear neutral colors and blend in with walls, so most of the time people don't notice I'm even there. But every
I
once in a while,
always know you're
every
there.
Every once in a while, someone notices.
Isn't it good enough to know that I always know you're there?
No. So, man, what's up? What's new?
Nothing, really. I'm home. I'm just, trying to fix my computer. It took me and Jason about an hour and a half to finally get on the damn Skype to do the show.
So your computer was going all crazy.
But we did it. Yeah, I don't know what my sister did to my computer, because when I'm gone, my sisters, Nikki and Jackie, they get on my computer, I guess, and they do crap. And for some reason, my mic wasn't working, so they did something with my mic.
Hmm.
But it's obviously working now.
It was probably the MySpace.
Yeah.
That darn MySpace.
The kids and their MySpace.
That darn MySpace.
What's funny is for some reason, my Skype signs on automatically. Even when I don't want it to. So, like, when my mom or my sisters are on, people will call me while my mom and my sisters are on the online, and my mom and my sisters, they just sit there and talk to my fans.
Mm.
Yeah, so like I'm starting to get like emails from people going like, "I talked to your mom yesterday." It's really creepy. Do you ever get emails from strangers telling you that I talked to your mom yesterday, Jason.
You know, I never have.
Nope. Dude, nobody talks to your mom?
No.
It's crazy. Okay? I'm not Brad Pitt.
No, you are not.
I never people add me on Skype all the time, and I never answer them. Okay? I'm just going to warn you guys right now. If you add me on Skype, I'm not going to answer your phone calls. Okay? So stop adding me and stop calling me, or I'm going to change my name.
He'll do it. He's just crazy like that.
I'll do it, and I'll climb on top of your house. Jeez Louise.
I know.
Of course, the fact that my Skype name is
Elmo3000
doesn't really help me hide at all.
Well, now that you just said it, you're going to get tons of people messaging you.
Can you bleep that?
I'm going to bleep it, but it won't be bleeped.
Can you replace it with a different name?
I'll replace it with something.
Replace it with something. Oh, God. Yeah, you know, that was pretty stupid of me.
That was, you know, I was, as soon as you said that, I was like, wow, that was classic Robert Benford right there.
Well, what's that supposed to mean? What, do you think I'm stupid? Do you think I'm retarded?
Of course not, Robert.
Do you think I'm
retarded? Of course
attarded?
Not, Robert. Calm down. Have a cookie, Robert.
Do you think I'm retarded?
Have a cookie, Robert.
Do you think I'm retarded?
Robert, have a cookie.
I'm not retarded.
No, you're not retarded.
I'm not retarded.
You're not retarded.
I'm not retarded. Okay. King of the Hawaiian shirt mustache people.
Hey, want to do a script?
Slicing Z's in people's shirts. Yeah, sure, let's do the scale. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to open up the script now. Hopefully my computer doesn't explode this time.
I certainly hope it doesn't.
It kind of has troubles with doing simple things like opening up, like, text files. There we go.
Yeah, we got a skit today. It's called, It's Time.
It's not done, you idiot. It says it's done downloading, but there's nothing there.
What?
Oh, God.
What's going on?
Hello?
Yeah, you there? Hello?
I don't know.
You don't know what?
I'm there. I'm here. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you fine.
Ah!
What's going on, man?
Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you. Hello? Man, something's going on.
You can hear me?
I can hear you fine.
Your voice sounds really weird. Okay, hold on. Just give me a second.
Okay. There's trouble.
Your voice sounds really slow.
There's trouble in Knoxtown. Let's disconnect and reconnect.
Hello? The crocodile won't stop looking at me wrong. Got a head this wide and this long. I can kill him any time, but I don't. I would if I could, but I can't, but I won't. Look at the smile on his face. He looks amazed that I'm putting up with his race. I'm not a dog, I don't go move. I'm a man just looking for something new. I found him lying in the grass in the mud. Didn't give a crap if it's bad or good. Had enough of his nonsense. Lying in the mud, acting like he's unconscious. Friend said he was dead, but his eyes were open. Thought that meant something, but I do know one thing. The croc was a prick, and he never said much. He's an animal, but he still sucks. The crocodile won't stop looking at me wrong. Got a head this wide and this long. I can kill him any time, but I don't. I would if I could, but I can't, but I won't. Look at the smile on his face. He looks amazed that I'm putting up with his race. I'm not a dog, I don't go move. I'm a man just looking for something new. Hey crocodile, do you like soda? And say yes or no, not sorta. But can only answer at all. I'll grab you by your tail and throw you into a wall.
How you figure, baby? I knew you were dead. I'm grabbing by the score ribbon out of your head. Look at your lap. You like biting. Stop laughing. I'm dying.
Dog crocodile won't stop looking at me wrong. Got a head this wide and this long. I can kill him any time, but I don't. I would if I could, but I can't, but I won't. Look at the smile on his face. It looks amazed that I'm pulling off with his race. I'm not a dog. I don't go move. I'm a man just looking for something new. Dog crocodile won't stop looking at me wrong. Got a head this wide and this long. I can kill him any time, but I don't. I would if I could, but I can't, but I won't. Look at the smile on his face. But I guess it's gonna be a while. I gotta go. It's like 8.
And we are back from our technical difficulties.
Yeah. Jesus Christ. There's Green Day crap all over my computer.
Green Day crap.
Man. I gotta put a password on this thing.
You got a Green Day virus.
No. Probably.
It's a new marketing tool. Infect computers with your advertising.
At least I don't have a 50 cents virus.
I believe it's 50 cent.
I like saying 50 cents. I don't know why, I just like saying it like that. Okay, do you have a problem with it?
Of course not, Nux.
See, that's not nice.
Nux!
Justin.
Justin?
Justin.
Sounds like a combination between Jason and Justin. Two people at once.
Justin. The amazing Jason. The Jason Raisin.
It's me.
Okay, let's do this. Yeah. Yes, I'm Roy.
Oh yeah, the skit.
Yeah, the skit.
I totally
the thing that
almost
destroyed my computer.
Yeah, man. Alright, so this is called It's Time.
Alrighty.
We got the energy flowing on, we got the flow going.
There's something flowing. I don't really want to know what it is. But okay, yeah.
Here we go.
Okay.
It's time. Ready? Here we go.
Actually.
Hey Roy, guess what time it is?
What time is it?
I said guess, man. You gotta guess. No freebies.
Greg, I'm allergic to bees.
I know, Roy. I know.
So what time is it?
One more time, Roy. Ask that one more time and that's it. You're in for a thrashing. Whop! Right in the head!
I'm allergic to bees.
We've gone past that bee part. It's just you and now, you and me now, Roy.
This is exciting. I feel like I'm finally going I feel like I'm finally doing something with my life.
Well, you're not, but go ahead and feel that way. Anything that keeps you from killing yourself.
Or the bees from killing me.
Yes, because you're allergic.
No, because someone's been arming the bees.
What time is it?
Is it time for sausage?
No, that wouldn't make sense. It's never time for sausage. What time is it?
Pickle time?
Absolutely not.
Pickly pickle. Pickle pickly pickly poo.
Yes, and pickly woo woo too, Roy. But that's not this time. Not time this is. Time! What time is it?
Time to wave some flags around. To show the true spirit of America.
No.
To enjoy our wonderful freedoms and liberties. To fly forth on an endless journey into the endless sky.
You're getting off point, Roy.
I've been stung.
Stung? Oh no, by a bee?
No, Greg. By a sense of accomplishment.
Roy, I'm leaving now.
You haven't told me what time it is!
It's time for me to leave.
Was that what time it was a few minutes ago?
A few minutes ago. It was a few minutes until it would become time for me to leave.
I don't understand this America, Greg.
Do not worry, Roy.
I have no choice but to worry. It's all I have left.
You still have time.
And a deadly allergic reaction to bee stings.
Yes, and that's something, Roy. You'll always have something.
So, where are you leaving to, Greg?
America, Roy. America.
Maybe America is really in your heart.
Really in my heart? Maybe it is. But I won't know for sure until a medical doctor splits open my chest and has a look.
I will never forget the lessons you taught me, Greg.
And I will never forget you, Roy.
Greg Smeg.
I will never forget you. And English muffins, they're really good.
Yeah, English muffins are good. Woo.
I'm off!
There he goes, off into the sunset. I hope you find America, Greg. I hope you find yourself.
Yeah, so that was our skit.
Yeah, see, that's what I almost died trying to read.
Yes, all of our technical difficulties, just to bring that to you.
Yeah. So how much time do we have left?
You know, it's hard to tell because we had to stop before. But I'm guessing about 15 minutes.
Ah, so, fan mail time?
Fan mail?
Fan mail, you know, fan mail. People, fans send us mail, and we look at the mail, and it's fans.
Yeah, sure, let me open up the box here.
You got your fan mail, you got your fan mail.
Alright, Kyle wants to know what kind of system I use for my special effects. The answer is Adobe After Effects.
I thought you hated Adobe.
I don't hate... No, I hate Adobe Premiere. I love Adobe After Effects. Totally different. From Xander, dear Knox and Jason, what are your favorite seasons of the year? I like all seasons. And seasonings. I'm a multi-season kind of person.
It reminds me of that one time when somebody asked what our favorite holiday was, and I was like, summer. And you were like, no, stupid. Summer's not a holiday. So this time, I'm going to bring an old joke back, and I'm going to say, my favorite holiday is, my favorite season is Christmas.
Favorite Christmas is Chris's favorite, man, my tongue is getting all tied.
I know. Welcome to my world.
It's like
that's
a little,
what I like all the
it's
time.
It's like a little gnome sitting inside my face. And he's like,
that's me. I'm
I will do some tricks.
Welcome to my world.
Yeah, a little gnome inside your face, too. And he's like, and he decides that he wants to do stuff that's unfortunate.
There's a lot of things in my face, Jason.
Yeah. So, want to do a movie review?
Okay, I guess we're done with fan mail, huh?
For now, until I can organize this and figure out which ones are good.
We just throw the fan mail. No more fan mail, we just take...
What movie have you seen recently, Robert?
Crumble up that fan mail. Just crumble up that fan mail.
Yeah.
Yeah, just crumbly.
You can stop crumbling, you don't have to crumble it that much.
Crumbly, 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 crumbly.
You're going crazy with the crumbling. What movie have you seen recently?
Oh, that is not crumbling. That is ripping.
And you gotta stop with the crumbling, man.
Summer. Okay. What movie have I seen recently?
Yes. Movie review.
Oh, God.
This is your only homework, man, to do a movie review.
Oh, I saw Employee of the Month.
Employee of the Month.
Yeah. It's not really doing that good, is it?
Did this movie move you?
It moved me. It moved me to the bathroom, and then I had to move myself right back and
right.
To see the rest of the movie, because I paid for the movie. I wanted to see all of it. Yeah.
How was it?
It was funny. I thought it was funny. It's not really. It doesn't look like it's doing that good, but I thought it was really good.
So you would give it the Robert Benfer seal of approval.
And by seal of approval, I mean I give it about an 8.
An 8. Well, good. Anything else you want to say about this movie for your review?
No.
You know, I think in all honesty, in total complete honesty, I can say without a doubt that the Knoxkast movie reviews are absolutely the most useless movie reviews ever put forth on the internet.
This whole show is the most absolutely useless thing on the internet.
I think so. You know, if in the future they come across Knoxkast and they want to put a footnote in the book of history about what Knoxkast did, they're going to put, took up various amounts of space, and that'll be it.
Aliens are going to see this, and they're going to think that we're all retarded like this.
Oh, I don't think so.
I
think this is a warming show. I think this is a show that warms your various organs.
Yep.
Warms your heart. toasts your spleen.
It doesn't warm my heart, Jason. You're putting words in my face.
No, that's the gnome.
Oh.
Anyway, the movie I'm going to review is the re-release of The Nightmare Before Christmas.
Oh yeah, you saw that.
Yeah, it originally came out 13 years ago, but they've re-released it just recently as a 3D film. Where you put on, like, glasses. Not like CG, but you put on 3D glasses and it, like, pops out.
Yeah, a lot of people are freaking out. They're like, why are they doing that? Why does everything have to be CG?
Personally, I think The Nightmare Before Christmas is a fantastic movie. It is, without a doubt, one of the best animated films ever created. And it is a movie that I hold very dear to my warmed-up heart.
Yeah.
And so, you know, I mean, there's a lot of people who are viewing this as just a marketing tactic, which I'm sure it is. It's Disney making a quick buck. Except the opportunity to see The Nightmare Before Christmas on the big screen again, because the last time I saw it was 13 years ago, on the big screen at least. And to see it not only that, but in 3D, was fantastic. It is really a good movie. Unfortunately, one of the things that happened in the last couple of years, it became a Hot Topic fad. And there's a lot of people who have gotten sick of it because of that, but it's still a fantastic movie. The visual style is very German expressionalist, kind of like most of Tim Burton's stuff.
Yeah.
That Tim Burton has a hand in. And it's just really a great, great movie. Definitely among the best of what Tim Burton and Danny Elfman and the director, Henry Selick, I think. Let me look that up. Because most people don't even realize that Tim Burton didn't actually direct this.
Yeah. I realized that.
I did too, except unfortunately I am a... even though I realized I never remember the actual director's name. Yeah, Henry Selick. I got it right.
Well, what about...
I was totally guessing too.
What about Corpse's Bride? What do you think?
I thought it was good. I didn't like it as much as I liked The Nightmare Before Christmas, but Corpse's Bride was pretty good as well. Fantastic animation, just absolutely some of the best stop motion I've ever seen in my entire life.
It looks like freaking CGI.
I know, it was that good, just ridiculous.
Because I just saw the movie like 3 weeks ago, and like when I saw the movie previews, I really did think it was a CGI film.
A lot of people did, because they've gotten so good at that stuff.
And I saw Tim Burton's name, I'm like, I didn't know he did CGI films, what the hell? I don't know if I want villain animation to be that good, though. If you want animation to look that perfect, then what's the point of making it stop motion?
Well, I think stop motion brings...
You might as well make it CGI if it's going to look that smooth.
Yeah, it sort of brings a... I think the stop motion aspect brought an extra element of realism that you can't get with CG to Corpse Bride.
Oh yeah, it's still cool.
I think so. I mean, I thought... It was really a fantastically well-made movie. It's one of the... You know, you see all these crappy CG movies coming out now, and then every once in a while they have a truly well-made movie like Corpse Bride come along. It's just refreshing.
Well, hopefully Villain will make it far.
Bargain Bin! Walmart!
That's my dream! People would die to be in the Bargain Bin, Jason.
I know. Well, some people would, you know.
What do you think of Villain?
Well, I haven't seen it yet.
No, I mean, the script.
I think the script is really good.
I think it's
one of those unique movies that you don't see. You know, the plot line is very basic. The plot line, I mean, there's tons of, of movies that have the basis in superheroes. Except the movie itself is totally different than you would expect it to be. In the fact that just the dialogue and everything else like that is completely unique. And you don't see any movie with that kind of dialogue ever, anywhere.
Yeah. I am proud of myself.
Yes.
All I gotta do is make the film now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we're at the time mark.
The time mark already?
Are we? No, we're not.
I see no mark.
Wait, how... I don't even know how long we're in. I think we got a couple more minutes.
Okay. Yeah. What about Spatial Madness? How's that?
It's coming along well. You know, I changed the artwork style early on, and so that's been taking me forever to freaking draw. But it is coming out really good.
Can you give us a rough like estimate of how like how far you are?
I'm pretty far in. I've only got I finished the majority of the artwork and a lot of the animation. I just have to render it out. So I probably have about a month's worth of work left, I guess. I don't know. I have absolutely no idea, to be perfectly honest.
All my voice work is finished, so I'm done with that.
Mm-hmm.
So it's all down to you.
Yes, it's all down to me.
All down to you. If you don't finish this movie, I'm going to have to drown you in the toilet.
That would be a pretty bad way to go.
I'll give you a swirly.
Swirly. Swirly.
But yeah, from what I've seen so far, the stuff you showed me, I think it's better than the original
script. Oh, God, yes. It's so far
ahead. Even the original script, even though like you changed the script a lot, even the original movie script is better than the short movie.
The short movie completely and totally sucks compared to this.
Yeah, it does.
It totally does. But yeah, everyone go see The Nightmare Before Christmas in 3D.
I'd see it, but I have nobody to see it with.
Go see it,
because
man.
My
you might not even
suck.
Be able to see it. It's only open in 168 theaters.
Really?
Yeah. I'm lucky there was one around here. One of the people who messaged me, Katrina, she messaged me, and she was like, oh, one of my favorite movies is coming out in 3D. And I was like, which is it? She's like, Nightmare Before Christmas. And I was like, whoa, how did I not hear about this? Since I would have killed myself if I didn't know about this, and I learned later on after it had stopped showing. Although, to be perfectly honest, they'll probably re-release it next year in 3D again, like they're doing with... Well, they're doing... Like, IMAX is doing that a lot now.
Yeah.
Re-releasing Christmas and holiday movies and stuff every year.
Mm-hmm. Maybe Villain will be in 3D someday.
That would be interesting.
That would be interesting. I'd be up in your faces.
Yeah. Robert Benfer in three dimensions.
In your living room.
Reaching out. Grabbing
your lap.
Coca-Cola from your lap.
Drinking Coca-Cola. Talking into it to make your voice sound really cool.
Yeah.
Man, I wish I had two bottles. I could play like an instrument.
Got another fan mail from David. He wants to know what a burrito is. You gonna get this one, Robert?
Well, since I'm from San Antonio, aka Mexican land.
You there?
Next fan mail.
You didn't answer, man. You didn't answer. Why aren't you
next
talking,
next fan mail.
Okay, fine. Okay. From Brian, he wants to know if either of us have been to Disney.
Bean, meat, or cheese wrapped in tortilla.
Well, thanks. That's very helpful. Alright, Brian wants to know if we've ever been to Disney World.
What?
Have you ever been to Disney World?
No! Well, I did when I was two.
I've been to Disney World a lot. My favorite park is Epcot. Nobody's favorite park is Epcot, but mine is.
I wanna go back to Disney World.
I love Epcot.
Epcot, what the hell is that?
Epcot, it's the land of tomorrow. Oh god, the phone is ringing.
Wow.
Multiple phones are ringing.
You gonna go get that?
I am. Hold on 1 second. Yeah, my phone's ring. I talk.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
Hello?
But
Hi.
Burritos are awesome.
Hi,
Sammy took
something.
Me to this one place called Freebirds, and their burritos are like freaking huge.
No.
They're like freaking 7 inches long. Okay. And I ate like a quarter of that because I'm a really skinny man. I don't really eat that much. But it kind of sucked actually. No, they were really good. They were good. Actually, I don't remember if it sucked or not. And it's kind of sad that I don't remember because it was actually 2 weeks ago. No, it was good because I put hot sauce on it, and I love the hot sauce. It was really hot. It was the hottest hot sauce I've ever had. But yeah, I love burritos. And when I find out somebody doesn't know what a burrito is, it shocks me.
I'm back.
Megan didn't know what a burrito was, and it shocked me. I almost died. I almost fell downstairs.
Downstairs?
I almost fell downstairs.
Oh, hey, the show's over.
But don't go to Freebirds. That's a hippie place. But the burritos are still pretty good.
The show's over, man.
It's over?
Yeah.
That's it?
We have to say goodbye.
Oh. All right, well. I guess that's it.
We're going to miss everyone very deeply.
I'm going to miss you all, but next week we're going to have our special Halloween episode.
Yes.
It's going to be really spooky.
Or slightly spooky. And
no, it's going to be very spooky. Ooh.
Or a tiny bit spooky.
Oh.
Yeah. So thanks for listening. Bye, everyone.
Goodbye.